here. We're ready to take on Route 3. Last time we took on Brock and steamrolled him. His underling actually gave more trouble, but we also burned through Meridian Forest quite rapidly, actually. A little faster than I thought I would be, so to say. And we're starting off strong as crit. We're about to evolve into Ivysaur 2, which is a much needed level up. I really need it. Because being my only Pokemon, that's gonna get annoying if that happens repeatedly. I feel like the max roll is being used on me over and over. But anyway, Route 3, we have a bunch of trainers that we'll be taking on. I doubt we'll even finish all of them. There's quite a few here. Though some of them are bug type users, bug catchers. And we also have the famous guy that likes to wear shorts. But otherwise, on Route 3, there is a patch of grass a little later in the route where you can catch Spearow if you haven't caught one at this point. It's there. I don't remember what the other encounter is, but there's one, another, or I shouldn't say, I don't remember the other old encounter. We've encountered it before, but there's a new encounter in there. That's what I've been trying to say, if I could speak properly. But is Jigglypuff, which I think is the worst Moonstone evolution in the game. Because in comparison to some of them later, like I already mentioned Nidoking, Nidoqueen as well, which the only reason you use Nidoqueen is because it went Body Slam by level up, if I remember correctly. But when it comes to comparison to Clefable, which we'll be hopefully talking about it and maybe seeing it in a coming dungeon, I'm getting my ass kicked by a Weedle. But Clefairy and Clefable, the only reason you wouldn't pick them over Jigglypuff and Wigglytuff is just the fact that Wigglytuff gets Body Slam, or I should say Jigglypuff, because Jigglypuff learns it 30-ish, I want to say 30, but here we go, we're evolving. This is the first time you're seeing evolution in this Let's Play, won't be the last. Ow, I don't know if it picked up that sound, but the note went really long for some reason. And ow, that hurt a lot. We're gonna heal. And we shouldn't have to heal that much anymore. We have an evolved Pokemon, which doesn't equal amazing stats, but it equals more than what we had before. But back to Clefable, Wigglytuff. It's basically, the best relation I can give it to is kind of a shitty Chansey in the regard that it doesn't have the amazing special stat it has in this game. And really, it's kind of a piss poor tank. So, if you want, it's not the worst Pokemon. It's not like Beedrill, Butterfree, Pidgeot, the crap we've encountered. I would say it's about the same as Raticate in usefulness. Oh my god, something we can actually use Vine Whip on. Thank god. I'm gonna go insane using Tackle this whole time. But yeah, that's all that appears on this route in Ekans. Where'd you get that? That's cheating. But oh my god, Rab. Alright, I guess it appeared here, so might as well talk about wrapping this generation does not stop you from switching out. It just stops you from moving. And it's irritating, as you can see, because it just does constant damage. You can't move, and if you're like me, you don't have another Pokemon to really switch out. So, well, I have a Spearow, but I'm not going to train that thing. It's to get me from one place to the other with Fly later. But, and the only reason Rapid's noticeable in a competitive standpoint, in-game it's just an annoyance. Unless you get really screwed, it shouldn't really bother you in-game. But in competitive, it's actually kind of funny because Dragonite, which is a legendary dragon Pokemon, woo! Not legendary, but a legend Pokemon, so to say, where it's just hard to raise and it's super strong in quotes. But the reason you would see in competitive play is merely because it learns Rapid as a Dratini. And I find that amazing. Also because I really hate Dragonite's design. Also, if you've ever seen its shiny form, I can't like it at all. I actually really like Dratini's shiny form, and then Dragonair's alright. But Dratini just looks really cute. Yeah, this is a good time as any to really talk about a couple differences from Generation 1 to 2. One of the biggest changes, one of the biggest things you'll probably notice if you haven't noticed already, or haven't learned about it, is the special stat. The special stat later in Generation 2 will split into special attack and special defense. What the hell is splat defense? Someone tell me that. What the fuck is that? But it'll split. I am slurring right now. Split into special attack and special defense later in Generation 2, but here it's one stat. That means that things with high special attack can also take a lot of own special attacks because they're the same stat. The Spearow's gonna hurt. But it means Chansey can throw off ice beams and thunderbolts better than a lot of Pokemon in the game merely because... Oh, that was awesome. Thank God I hit. But it shows that one stat is not the way to go, and they fix it, but it's also what makes Alakazam, which is a psychic type later that we'll be seeing a lot of, but it's able to tank really well on the special end merely because it has a high special attack, and so it's actually really strong. But later it splits into two stats. And that's why some Pokemon are actually really tanky here in this generation. Anything else that's obvious that I haven't gone over? I don't think so. Nope, nothing's coming to mind, so I guess we'll just be battling trainers with our Ivysaur. Ugh. Intriguing. I believe we already talked to the shorts guy, and I totally did not mention it when we were fighting him. I think he's the one with the Spearow. Sorry about that, I don't really care for it. I don't find the joke or the running gag funny. There's a girl in Emerald, I believe. I don't think she was there in Ruby and Sapphire, but it's like a potential double battle, and she says something on, I don't remember the exact words, but that's like, it's very innuendo what she says, and it has something to do with her Pokemon, and that's the stuff that I find hilarious. But the shorts guy, not really. And I believe we have two trainers left on this route, so we'll actually be finishing it. And the patch of grass you saw below, you can catch Jigglypuff there. I think it's a somewhat rare encounter, 5% around there, maybe 10%. I don't remember it being that high. But if you want a Wigglytuff, or if you're just a fan of, I think it appears in the anime. I didn't watch that much of the anime, but I think it appears. Yeah, probably does. We're level 18, and at this point, if you caught another Pokemon, of course, unless you grinded, you won't be as high, but that's the perk of only having one Pokemon right now. But it also has a con in that I don't get a lot of super effectives. So, that'll change eventually. And this is the last trainer, I believe she has a Jigglypuff. I did not touch you, I'm facing the other way. That's... And then you... Did you touch me? That Jigglypuff sprite looks creepy, and it's an example of how disgusting some of these sprites look. Like, I understand we're in a weird way with these sprites, but I think we'll see a Golbat. No, not that soon, but in quite a few hours, actually, of gameplay, but we'll see Golbat, and it's quite disgusting what they did to him for his sprite work. What do you have to say? I better take a rest. That tunnel from Cerulean takes a while. That is actually impossible. You're a liar. Now I'm going ahead, which is our next dungeon. I tripped over a rocky Pokemon Geodude. Okay, you suck at this one. There's a hidden item. Where is it? Or is it just in Fire Emblem? No. Okay, I'm lying again. I'm so sorry about that. Not really, I don't care. You should store them via the PC. We're gonna heal. And overall, I think that'll wrap this up. Actually, now there's a guy in here that will offer you a Magikarp. I got a deal just for you. A swell Magikarp. What do you say? I'll talk about Magikarp probably next time while I'm going over the Pokemon in Mount Moon, but next time we'll be stepping foot into Mount Moon Tunnel Entrance. See you then.